I can tell you one thing, if you only watch the highlights a little bit, it could have been 8-0.
Easy.
And not easy. Like, oh, like, one. Hard out to, like, yeah, or maybe 8-1. We give a little bit credit to Real Madrid, but now it's a masterclass.
It was a procession.
Great position.
Perfect. Yeah. But here's actually where you see no lenience whatsoever, what Foss touched on in the pre-show with Simeone. You don't get any lenience. But he'll love you, he'll work with you, he'll explain exactly what you do. But you do one thing wrong, and that's you're out, because then somebody else will do your job.
Yeah, and you represent the club, and you represent the fans, and you represent
You were watching this and saw this, and straight away you saw this coming.
Oh, look, as soon as he started chipping there, I mean, that's Atletico Madrid love that. You know, that's what they're waiting for. That's their whole plan. Their whole plan is to just wait for the pass, you know. And he tries to chip the ball, and he's gone. And you see this touch here from Morata. It's horrible. But Morata, we're saying off air here, is a perfect example of a player who come in and is going to improve in this culture, in this regime under Simeone. You can see the problems they have in central defence. And this is Nacho involved in both, but Ramos wasn't in this game against... involved in this goal. But look at that defender. He actually doesn't know where Lewandowski is. The other one tries to recover, gets nowhere near the ball. It's just a mess. So Morata could have had one. Wow, Felix, wow. So it was 125 million euros, close to $200 million Australian for a 19-year-old. And look how good he is. You know, he's in the first 3 minutes. What is it? The first minute, actually. An assist.
Beautiful
straight away,
pass.
And then he gets himself in for a goal. And then what about one-on-one in the box against Nacho, where he just throws him and goes? And it's just, you know, and he's almost got the ball, you know, over Courtois, where he's tried to just lift the ball. Just absolutely incredible. So there's only been one team here. It's been an incredible performance. And even, you know, this may well be pre-season, of course, but even back in Madrid, don't worry, the fans are going completely crazy, because you don't, you know, to get the opportunity to really smash Real Madrid, their most hated rivals. My word, doesn't matter in any game, any time, any city, this is something very special for them.
Paddy,
look at this, 4-2,
that's a mess.
And how Kroos, how Ramos, how Marcelo.
Look at the runs.
Just get run over.
They're just running.
Quicker, you know, looking forward all the time, playing quick. But actually playing as though it's a real game, because for them it is a real game. And not just because it's Real Madrid, but because that's the way Atletico Madrid are. They are a working team, and they play the same way every time. He's a beautiful turner. It's wonderful work from Saul here.
Oh, fantastic.
A beautiful little ball.
And but you see, only one player drops, and in this case it's Marcelo. In the other one against Bayern Munich, it was
great ball.
Another centre defender. Before it was Ramos, so always somebody is dropping early, and then that's where they always get the space and find the space, and behind it's unreal. But it looks like a very fit team against a very unfit team. That's how it looks like.
And Foz, we talked about culture before the game, the situation with Bale culturally, and just something seems wrong with Real and Zizou.
Yeah, so look, Real is the most successful club in the history of the game. So, you know, but at the moment, they're in real crisis, because they had Lopetegui come in, and then, you know, Solari, and then they've brought in Zidane, who has left when he was very much at the top. And he's come in now again. You know, I thought he should have had a diving header there. I reckon he would have scored 100%. And now he's come in, and all of a sudden he's got these issues with various players and Bale and this and that. It's clear they're in a bit of disarray, and it's a very difficult time for them. Whereas at the other end, it's a very different culture. And in recent times, it's been a very successful one. And what Simeone's done is, you know, as everyone is aware, is quite amazing. He brought them from really the second tier of Spanish clubs to the top tier of world clubs, and that's... You know, can't be underestimated, the level of ability and personal kind of character and charisma that he's been able to bring to this team. He really represents the club, represents the team as a former player. Of course, he won the double, I think, back in late, might have been 96 with them.